Hi, hello children. How are you all? Welcome back to my class. So children, we have successfully completed our maths part 1 textbook. So take your maths part 2 textbook. So children, today we'll start your new lesson of maths, that is division. So open page number 1. Okay, so this chapter number 6, division. So first we'll learn equal distribution and grouping. Okay. Latha had 12 balloons. She wanted to distribute them equally among her 4 friends. How many balloons does each one get? So Latha, she has having 12 balloons. She wanted to distribute them equally among her 4 friends. Now you have to calculate that how many balloons does each one will get. Okay, so first you can see, first she gave one balloon to each of the 4 friends. Okay, what she will do first? She'll give one balloon to each of her friends. So here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. So 12 minus 4 is 8. Now Latha is having 8 balloons. 8 balloons remains with Latha. Okay, next, again she gave one balloon to each. Again she gave one balloon to each. So 8 minus 4. So 8 minus 4 is 4. Means it is the balloons remains with Latha. Next, remaining 4 she gave one each. So again she gave one balloons to each of her friend. So 4 minus 4 is 0. So therefore 12 is shared among 4 each. Yes, 4 each having, you can see 3 balloons. So therefore 12 is divided into how many groups? 1, 2, 3. Divided into how many groups? 3 groups? No. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 friends are there, right? So 12 is divided into 4 groups of 3 each, means 3 balloons. So therefore 12 divided by 4 is 3. So 12, it is the number of balloons divided by 4. 4 means friends. How many friends she is having? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 friends is 3. 3 is nothing but it is a number of balloons each of the friend get. Yes, how many balloons they got? 1. 3. Right? Each of a friend got 3 balloons. So therefore 12 divided by 4 is 3. So the process of sharing or grouping equally means dividing equally. Understood, children? And here you can see, here we used subtraction. Can you see this? Yes. 12 minus 4, 8. 8 minus 4, 4. 4 minus 4, 0. Right? So here we can say that division is repeated subtraction. Division is repeated subtraction. Understood, children? Now let us see what is the sign of this division. Now tell me, this is a sign of addition. This is a sign of subtraction. This is a sign of multiplication. Now this is the, see, this is the sign of division. Okay, so this is the sign of division. Understood, children? Okay, now let's take exercise part. Page number 3, exercise 6.1. Divide the 12 balls into groups of 3. So you have to divide all these 12 balls into groups of 3. Means you have to divide these balls into groups of 3. Okay, so let's do it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 1 group, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yes, how many groups are there here total of 3 balls? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, how many groups are there? 4 groups of their 3 balls. Okay, next, divide the fish into groups of 4. You have to divide all these fishes into groups of 4. Okay, let's divide it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Next, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 next 1 2 3 4 okay now tell me in how many groups we have divided these fishes 1 2 3 4 5 5 groups right so each group is having how many fishes 4 fish groups of 4 fish right so in the same way you try to do this remaining by yourself okay children now children come to the page number 4 second main put the beads in the string so that there are same number of beads in each string okay so first let us take one example put 9 beads into 3 strings okay you have to put 9 beads into 3 strings okay how many strings are there here 1 2 3 you have to put 9 beads into 3 strings but how you have to put each time you have to put 1 bead to the string okay each time you have to put 1 bead okay here you can see first 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 okay now how many beads are there in each string 3 are there 3 plus 3 is how much 6 plus 3 is 9 so now let us take one more example put 20 beads into 5 strings okay so 20 beads into 5 strings so let us put it first 1 1 1 1 1 so 1 2 3 4 5 so we have to minus 5 from this 20 so 20 minus 5 how much it will be 15 yes now how many beads remains with us 15 again you have to put 1 bead 1 1 1 1 1 okay 1 2 3 4 5 yes so again minus 5 15 minus 5 is 10 right how many remains with us now 10 beads okay again we have to put 1 bead 1 1 1 1 1 means 1 2 3 4 5 so 10 minus 5 is 5 so how many beads remains with us 5 beads right again we need to put 1 bead so 1 2 3 4 5 yes so now how many remains with us nothing yes so here 5 minus 5 is 0 isn't it now how many beads are put in a 5 strings 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 right yes how many 20 beads understood children in the same way what you have to do here put 24 beads into 4 strings so each time you have to put 1 bead in each string first you have to put here 1 1 1 1 then you have to subtract that bead suppose here 1 1 1 1 means 1 2 3 4 so 24 minus 4 is 20 right again you have to put another bead okay in the same way you have to put all the beads till nothing is remains with you you should have 0 beads understood then you came to know that how many beads you have put in each string means in 4 strings understood children okay so in the same way try to solve this remainings by yourself okay now children come to the page number 5 relation between division and multiplication now let us see what is the relationship between the division and the multiplication children can you see here these are the flowers right so these are the flowers 3 times 4 is 12 so here how many groups are there here how many sets of flowers are there 1 2 3 so 3 times 4 4 means how many flowers are there in each set or in each group 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 so 4 so totally how many flowers are there here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 so 3 times 4 is 12 so 3 it is a what it is it's a number of sets means number of group 4 is how many flowers are there in each group so here 12 is overall means total number of flowers. So here you can see 4, yes, 3 times 4. So 4 into 3 is equal to 12. 4 threes are 12. 4 it is, what it is 4? Yes, what is this 4? Means it is a number of flowers in each group. How many flowers are there? 4. Into how many groups are there? 1, 2, 3. Total 4 threes are 12. So this is the multiplication form. So this is called the multiplication form. Yes, now let us do it in the division form. Okay, here 12 flowers, we will take this 12 flowers are divided. We have to use the sign here. Which sign it is? Yes, it's a division sign. So 12 divided by, so the 12 flowers, these are the flowers, total number of flowers here. 12 flowers are divided into how many groups? 3 groups. 3 groups is equal to the 3 groups of flowers. The 3 groups of 4 flowers. So here 12 flowers are divided into 3 groups of 4 flowers. So okay, 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. Okay, later on I will tell you how to divide these numbers. Okay, you just know that how to write the multiplication form and the division form. Here you can see, children, can you tell me what this number is called in the multiplication? This is the multiplicand, multiplier, product. Do you remember? Multiplicand, multiplier, and this is called product. Okay, so while going to write this into the division form, first you have to take this product 12 divided by, then we'll take this multiplier and the answer will be multiplicand. Okay, now let us take one example. So here, these are in the multiplication form. You can see here, 3 fours are 12. Yes, so 3 fours are 12. It is in the multiplication form. So now let us see how to write this into the division form. Okay, so here, 12 divided by 12. First we have to take, yes, product. So 12 divided by, then multiplier we have to take, 4 is equal to, so 12 divided by 4 is equal to, here the 3, multiplicand is 3 here. Yes, so here 4 into 3 is equal to 12, 4 threes are 12. It is in the multiplication form, right? First we have to write the product 12 divided by, then take this multiplier 3 is equal to 4. The answer will be, the answer after the division, the answer, whatever the answer we'll get, it will be, yes, multiplicand only here. Yes, so every multiplication form has a corresponding division form. Let us take another examples here. Can you see here? 6 into 2 is equal to 12. 6 twos are 12. Right. Now let us write into a division form. So each multiplication form will have a two division form. So first one here you can see. First you have to take this product. So 12 divided by, we'll take this multiplier first. 2 is equal to 6, multiplicand. Answer should be multiplicand here, right? So 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. Next, we'll take this product same as it is. Next, we have done with this multiplier. Now we'll take this multiplicand. 6 is equal to, the answer will be multiplier. Yes, can you see here? 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. This is the multiplicand here. And 12 divided by 6, here we have took the multiplicand. So answer will be multiplier. Understood, children? So here, therefore, division and multiplication are related to one another. Understood? What is the relation between division and multiplication? Okay. Now, children, come to the exercise part, which is there on page number 6. Exercise 6.2. Fill in the blanks. First one, if 7 into 3, if 7 into 3 is equal to 21. 7 threes are 21. Then 21 divided by 3 is equal to dash. How much it will be? Here they have given the multiplication form. You have to convert it into a division form. So here they have took the product first. Then the multiplier is here. The answer will be, yes, multiplicand. So we'll write here 7. Okay. Next, if 9 into 6 is equal to 54. 9 6 are 54. Then 54 divided by 6 is equal to how much? 54, the product is here. Divided by 6, the multiplier is here. The answer will be multiplicand, right? Means 9. Yes. Now let us take one more example. If 5 into 8, 5 8s are 40, 5 into 8 is equal to 40, then 40 divided by dash is equal to 5. Yes, so 40, what it is? It's a product divided by, the answer is 5, which is multiplicand. So the here, what we have to write? So we have to write 8. Yes, so 40 divided by 8 is equal to 5. Here they have given product, here they have given the multiplicand. So answer here, what will be the answer here? Yes, it's a multiplier, means 8. Understood, children? In the same way, you try to do this remaining by yourself. Now come to the second main. Match the division form with the multiplication form by drawing a line. So here they have given the division form. You have to match it with a correct, which form? Multiplication form. Okay. So first one is 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4. So first, where is the 4 here? Here is a 4. So into 2 is there. Yes, 4 2s are 8. Right. So 8 is a, what it is here? The 8 is product, means here the 8 is, can you see this? Yes. So 4 into 2 is equal to 8, means this is the right answer for this. Yes. So in the multiplication form, in the division form, the numbers should be same. Okay. Here you can see the 8 is here. The answer is 4. Here in the multiplication form, 4 is here. And here the 2 is here and the 2 is here. And when we multiply this, the answer 8. Here you can see the 8. Yes. So all the numbers should be here in the multiplication form. Whether whatever they are in the multiplication form, those numbers will be in the division form, but in some another way. Okay. So let's take one more example. 20 divided by 4 is equal to 5. So where is the 5 here? Here is one 5 is there. Yes. So 5 is there. Next 4. Here it is 3. Here is a 4. Means it is wrong. Next. Here one more 5 is there. 5 into 4. So here 4 is there. Yes. So 4 5s are 20. 20 is there. Yes, means it's a right answer. Okay, next take another example. 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. Where is the 9 here? Here is a 9. Yes, so where is the, here is 9 into 2. Where is the 2 here? Here is a 2. 9 2s are 18. Where is the 18 here? It is there. Yes, it's there here. So, means this is a right answer. Understood, children? Whatever the numbers are there in the division form, it should be in the multiplication form. Whatever the numbers are in the multiplication form, it should be in the division form, but in some another way. Okay. Children, in the same way, you try to do this remaining by yourself. Next comes the third main. For each multiplication form, write the corresponding division form. Here is a multiplication form. You have to write in the division form. Okay. First, let us take one example here. 9 into 8 is equal to 72. 9 8s are 72. Right. First, what you have to write? Yes, you have to write the product here. 72 divided by, first we'll take this 8 here, multiplier 8, and the answer will be, of course, multiplicand 9. Okay. Next, we'll write this product only. 72 divided by, so we have done with this multiplier. Next, we have to take this multiplicand. So, 9 is equal to, the answer will be 8. Yes, understood. Now let's take another example here, which is there on page number 7. 7 into 6 is equal to 42. 7 6 are 42. First, what you have to write? 7 6 or 42? Yes, 42. We'll write here 42. Yes, so next, divided by 6. We'll write 6 first. The answer will be, of course, the remaining number, that is 7. Next, we'll write 42, same, divided by, we have done with the 6. Now, we have to write the 7. 7, and the answer will be, of course, 6. Understood, children? So, in the same way, you try to solve these two remaining by yourself.